Amen. In this house, hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is a word from the Lord. Amen. That word will be derived from Luke, the 23rd chapter. Amen. The word verses 24 through 46. Amen. Amen. Luke 23. Listen for the word of the Lord in the Message translation. By now it was noon. The whole earth became dark. The darkness lasting 3 hours, a total blackout. The temple curtain split right down the middle of the veil. Jesus called loudly, "Father, I place my life in your hands." Then he breathed his last breath. Man, just for a few minutes, I only have seven. Amen. I would like to preach from this fall. Let it go. Look at somebody say, L-I-G. Let it go. 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 Brothers and sisters, Frankie Beverly and Maze, y'all know Frankie Beverly and Maze, amen. They're feel-good type of writers, amen. Frankie Beverly and Maze, amen, wrote a song entitled Before I Let Go. This is one of my favorite songs because Frankie Beverly and Maze is one of my favorite artists and groups because Frankie Beverly and Maze has the potential and Frankie Beverly and Maze has the tendency to give it to you raw and 100. Amen. Do y'all want to know what Frankie Beverly and Maze said? Amen. Oh, no, don't let you. Ain't too saved to know this. Let's say, I want to make sure I'm right, girl. Oh, before I let go. Yeah, you know, I thank God sun rises and shine on you. You know there's nothing, there's nothing I would not do. Oh, no, before I let go. Oh, I would never. Before I let go. And brothers and sisters, Frankie Beverly and Maze is talking about a honeymoon experience. They're talking about an experience when you're in love and you're in that stage of love. But I'm convinced that there are times when we have to learn that the honeymoon stage has to be over. And brothers and sisters, I'm afraid for the church because we're so used to God giving us what we want. But when God doesn't give us what we want, we quit on God. But can you look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's a moment in your life where you got to learn how to let that thing go. You got to learn how to let go what they said. You got to learn how to let go what they did. You got to learn how to let go of your insecurity. Look at your own self and say, I got to let that thing go. So the question is, why is it important for us to let go? I'm glad you asked the text, Pastor Tate. I only have about 5 more minutes. Praise the Lord. Y'all can't take up all my time. Beloved, this is what Jesus showed us in the text. He shows us how to let go because the text says, y'all still got your Bible open. The text says, it was noon, it was dark. When you're learning how to let go, you must understand, number one, you must understand how to navigate through dark times. The text says that it is dark. And God does God's best work in the dark. I know that we know that God is the light, that God is the God of day, but I believe that God is also the God of the darkness. I believe that God does his best work in the dark. So when it's dark in your life, you want to sit back and relax because the Lord is working on a mountain. Can you grab your neighbor one time and say, oh, if it's stuck in your life, the Lord is working on the mountain. He's working on something, and he can't tell you what he's working on. So while you're in the dark, you might as well clap your hands and give him glory. Don't sit down and take up my time. Amen. Not only must you understand that you have to navigate through the dark time, but you must also understand, number one, you must navigate through the dark, but number two, my promise, number sit down, you must understand that you must humble yourself to the Lord. You have to humble yourself. Jesus says, Father, into your hands, not into my hands, not into my mother's hands, not into my father's hands, not into the hands of Facebook, because that's where y'all go, not into the hands of Instagram, not into the hands of Twitter, but you can work on it, and if I give it over to you,
deposit. Make a deposit. Come on, overseer, take. There's a story. I promise I'm not going to sit down. There's a story of a young boy who was stuck in a house fire. Somebody say house fire. And this house fire is going on. And the boy's mother is not there. The boy's brother is not there. The boy's sister is not there. But the neighbor called his father. And his father shows up to the scene. After leaving work, distressed, he's distressed because his son is stuck in the fire. Y'all still with me? And the father can't go in the house because if he goes in the house, that means that both of them will die. But down below, the father waves at the son. And the father says, son, I need you to jump from the window. And the son says, well, daddy, it's smoke in the room. And it's dark outside. And I'm on the fourth floor.
Ah!